Hi everyone, I'm Sarah from Inkno, and welcome to the ClassPoint channel. The ClassPoint channel is filled not only with ClassPoint tips and tricks, but also tips on using EdTech tools in your classroom. So if you like the sound of that, don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on notifications to stay updated on when we release a new video. Today's video is actually on an EdTech tip, which is how to remove a background on an image in your PowerPoint presentation. So there's no need to buy a subscription or a pro version of an editing software. You can do this background removal right in your PowerPoint presentation. So this is handy if you only want one piece of a image, or if you want to layer some images, or just have that transparent background. In this video today, I am using PowerPoint 2019, but as long as you guys have a PowerPoint or an Office version 2007 or newer, you should have these background removal features. So we're actually going to use two different methods on removing backgrounds of your images in PowerPoint. So the first one is for images with a more simple background, and the second is for images with a more complex background. So on my slide here, I do have both of these types of images, and we're going to start with the first method, which is setting a transparent color. So this image that I have here is just a plain black background. And once I click on the image, I just need to go up to the picture tools and the format tab on the top ribbon. From there, you'll see all of the different photo editing tools that PowerPoint provides you, which is actually quite a lot, which is very nice. But we're gonna go over to the color drop-down menu and click on set transparent color. From there, we can just hover over the color we want to set as transparent. And once we click, the background will disappear and you now have a transparent image. If you need to reset the image back to its normal state, you can always just click on Reset Picture. Now, the second method for more complex backgrounds will go to this second image here. And in the same way, once I click on it, it just go to Picture Tools in the Format tab. And this time we're gonna click on the Remove Background tool. So PowerPoint does have this, but as you click on it, you can see it turns everything a pink color. So sometimes PowerPoint doesn't know exactly which to keep and which colors to get rid of. So luckily you have the option to mark areas to keep or remove if they have gotten that a little bit wrong. So as you can see, there are some areas that we do want to keep on this image. So if I just take my pencil and I can draw a quick line over the parts of the image that I want to keep, and usually PowerPoint does a really good job of noticing that, and it takes other colors that are around that and makes it not transparent anymore. So you can do as many lines as you need to make sure that everything of your image is going to be keeping that you want. And once you're all complete, you can say keep changes. And you'll see that now your image is also transparent. If after you do that, you notice some mistakes, you can always go back into the remove background and mark areas to keep or delete again, or you can discard all of the changes. So now that your images are with a transparent background, you're free to resize them and move them around on your slide as you see fit. In addition, you can always copy and paste these images in a Word file, in your Teams, or in an email if you want. So you can always just use PowerPoint for this photo editing tip instead of just for your presentations. However, we do have to go over some of the limitations of PowerPoint's background removal features. So it's not perfect, and if you can see that sometimes it won't always take out what you want. So in this photo, for example, if I set the transparent color as white, it's not gonna remove everything. Since these images are a little bit gradient, it doesn't know exactly what to remove. So just be careful when you are doing some of your images that not all of them might work out perfect. Now there are a couple other examples that I want to go over. So that's for gradient images. This one is for images that are all very similar in color. So if we do the background removal for this one, you'll see that it does take out quite a bit. So you can do mark areas to keep, but it just might be a little bit tedious. And lastly, I want to go over some strands of hair. So usually PowerPoint kind of struggles with this if there's a lot of fine lines. So for example, if we go here, we can do set transparent color for this one. And it does a pretty good job, but there is a little bit of white around this little jumping excited girl. So just be warned when you guys are doing this that it might not be perfect every time. But it should get the job done while you're doing your presentations or if you don't have access to other editing tools. I hope you guys enjoyed this video today. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and hit subscribe so that you can stay updated. Have a great day. I'll see you next time.